Hello everyone. So time now for our next Node.js for a Beeper episode. And I thought of, rather than directly going into the database, it makes sense to, you know, now understand what are events and have a look at them. And then from events, we'll jump to streams, streams to buffer, and then to database. So we'll take a small detox of events, right, in this episode. So till now, what we have got so far is a Node.js Express application running, which reads data from EKKO, right, EKKO file, and which has our different plans and purchase orders, as well as the PO item file. So all we are doing is we can read the data from this, and we can write the data also to EKKO. That is what we have done so far. So maybe in interest of time, let me then quickly copy path. So let's maybe now just move to that namespace, right? And let's run our app. So our app is now running, and if we just see in request.http, right, and I open it here. So if I just send it a get request to no endpoint, which is a blank one, so what we do is we just console log hello, and if I just request data for EKKO, it gives me EKKO. If I request data for EKPO, it gives me EKPO, right? So as soon as some request will come, we can log it here, but same thing, we'll have to do it at a number of places with same code, right? And it would have been more simple. All I have to do is just emit an event to somebody and let that whoever is going to catch that event, and they can do something, right? And imagine this thing, there can be multiple receiver also. Same event, multiple receiver. So you cannot have the same code copied everywhere, right? So that is why event-driven programming is very helpful. And even in your SAP world also, you will see that extensions are now developed based on event-driven programming. You will receive and you will register for an event, and you will wait whenever that event happens, you'll get the data and you'll do whatever you want to do. So what we will try to do is, we'll try to do the same, okay? So let's then try to get this going. So we'll say first, let events is equal to require events module. We need events module, right? And we'll create an object of it. We call it as event emitter. And then I say, as soon as I receive this event, what is that event? For example, PO data, right? I want to call, for the timing, I just want to log that event received. So the whenever this event PO data will be called, right, will be emitted, this will be our catcher, right? And it will catch, and it will, this function module is like a callback. It's like a callback. Whenever this PO data event is received, you basically run this event received. And where we will emit it, we will, let's say, let me copy this, and I say emit. Our event name is PO data. So PO data, right? And I just say save. So I hope it is now working. So for example, if I hit now EKKO endpoint, which is this one, I shall see this being logged in the console. So if I just say send request, you see event received. Now, and we got the response also, that is okay. And now if I make it copy it twice, right? And I say, this is my second receiver. and I say event received another receiver, right? And if I now again send the request, you see event received another receiver. So the benefit of this is that rather than, you know, copy pasting code into each tabs and all, now all you need to do is emit an event and you are going to basically catch even multiple receivers can be there and they can do stuff. Now you must let's then have PO data, and rather than how do we, you know, let's add it to EKK PO also for the time being, right? So now if I send to EKPO, again I'm missing two times. Why? Because I have got two receivers, right? And if I send it to EKKO, then also again I will receive two times, which is very good, which is as per the expectations. Now you must be thinking, it is coming the same for EKKO and EKPO. How do I pass data from the place where the event is raised to the place, you know, to the subscriber? This is a publisher, event publisher, and that is a subscriber. This is a subscriber. How do I pass data from here? So all you need to do is, for example, I want to pass this data parameter. So all I need to do is comma, right? And same here, right? And I can use it here. So what I will say is data, and maybe I can write it also with a space. Same here, I can write it with a space, correct? So now we have data being passed from emitter to the receiver. For example, if I now say send request, got an error which says data is not defined. Where it is not defined, request.query.data. I forgot it here, right? So now if I say send request, I have EKKO, right? And if I send request to EKPO, I get EKPO. So that is how you can kind of send and receive the data via events, right? This is like you have n number of places you want to enable logging, you can do that. And you can, you know, in fact I can save the data from here to the database. But you must be thinking that, okay, then maybe, for example, we only want that this event to be run only once, okay? So this one shall only, as soon as it receives an event, it shall not run again, even if multiple requests comes. So for example, I can then say, instead of on, I'll say once, right? So for example, the moment I said send request, I received EKKO, because there were two. Now again I will send another request. In that case, all I am expecting is this console logging, because for this it has already received its data once. So if I say this, you see, so it depends on how do you want to use it. Sometimes when an application is initialized, you want to use it, then you can use this. If you want to use it every time, you can use this, right? So this is the how basically we can use events. Okay, so now let's say that we want to know how many listeners are there, right? So what we can do is we can use console.log event meter dot listeners, right? And then listener count, then you need to pass listener count, then you need to pass the event name, and then it shall log the listener count. So let's send it a request. For example, I send EKPO, right? Or EKKO, I send EKPO. So it received, it says there's a listener count is one, because I have it as one. So the moment this runs, it switched off, right? So it gets one. Now if I change it to on, and now if I run send request again, now you see you have two. So there are two active listeners. And in case you also want to see what those listeners are, it can show that also to you. So for that you have raw listeners. I think this is a correct method, because I might be wrong. So let's just send that request. So now you have this, and there are two functions which we have definitely defined here. Let me close this. These are the two functions. One is this function, another is this function. So till now what we have understood is that, okay, in case we need to we can use these events to actually add value to our running Node.js app by basically adding logging, right? You can do a number of things. For example, the moment you get a request for a purchase order, you can raise an event. That event subscriber, for example, this one, it can go to a different system, get some data and come back. Or there can be three different systems on which you want to get the data from. So there can be three subscribers. So that is why it was very important to discuss about this concept. And I hope you understand now events better, right? So now in our next episode, I know this is a small one episode, but I think because events in itself is a very interesting concept, and it makes sense to understand it, spend some time here. So in our next one, we'll talk about streams, and streams are related to events, and we'll talk about buffers. And then once that is done, then we'll bring in MongoDB and other stuff. So till then, thanks for watching, and keep learning, keep sharing, stay safe. Bye bye, take care.